during the busy holiday season, at least I know for me, I like to take this chance to kind of sit back, relax, and forget about all the stress, all the gifts that haven't been either ordered or wrapped or last minute cooking and everything that's got to get taken care of. And just for this time, sit back, enjoy some incredible performances by some really outstanding people. So with that, I give you the Fall Holiday Concert.
Thank you. Thank you. That was Josh Blue and Matt Mendoza on the violin solo. This next piece is really very interesting. The composer is a pretty well-known composer in kind of this contemporary music for advanced high school orchestras field. And he wrote this piece for a high school somewhere else in the country that had lost a member of their orchestra too young. And so the school asked him to write this piece kind of in his memory. And the student that they wrote the piece for was really into like metal music and also really loved to play the cello, which actually describes way more of the students on this stage than you'd expect. I think that I really like this piece a lot. The composer does a good job of kind of infusing some like really subtle hints at metal music and also having this really beautiful, sentimental, but positive message throughout the piece. So I hope you enjoy it. It's called Lyric Metal. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Sierra Lapp, and I'm one of the cool presidents of this concert jazz band, along with Nick Paul, who's going to be right now. Tonight, we'll be playing Patient Fight Song, which is a song by Charles Mingus, who's a famous jazz bassist. And this was written at a time when there was a lot of fighting going on in the streets, and Mingus even said that he wouldn't be able to play it if he didn't think about all the persecution and all the sadness that was going on, all the hatred that was going on. And so to prepare, we've been getting angry a lot and just kind of blasting it out, so hopefully we're all super just bad about schoolwork and whatever else is going on. We'll be featuring first Nick Paul on the bass, then Emma Waddell on the tenor saxophone, Jill Kitt on the alto sax, Eli Hayden on trombone, and myself on trombone as well. And Dan Gilman, how could I forget?
We're working on the top of the jet, don't worry. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. All right, good evening, everyone. Good evening, everyone. Thank you for your patience. I don't know if some of you guys remember, but you know, my first year in West Hartford, I taught at elementary school, and one of the coolest things and the best logistical things was when we went to the Bushnell and we had Interrel, and we had the choir rise up from the pit. So I'm going to submit to Mr. Zatoon and Mr. Mayo that when we redo the auditorium, that we have a movable pit so that we don't have to do a scene change. So thank you very much for your patience. Really appreciate that. Two things. One, I'd like to acknowledge RJ Michaels, who had a fantastic drum set solo that we forgot to acknowledge, so let's give RJ a big hand. And two, just because we have obviously student speakers, I just want to say on behalf of the administration and especially the music team, happy holidays, have a wonderful new year. Thank you for entrusting us with your children. We have such a wonderful, wonderful job. Every day we get to come in and work with such fantastic students. We are so appreciative and humbled by the work that they do and the commitment they have, and that all starts in your homes, and we are so appreciative. So thank you very much for all your support. We really appreciate it. Thank you.
The piece that we just played is entitled Kutsta by John Vanderbus, and it is a gypsy dance, a story to it. We played the third set of a four-movement piece, playing all the records to be making long, we look like we sit here so blah blah. Anyway, it's folk dances related to Slavonic folk music by other composers such as Brahms and Brack, and, but all the melodies in that piece were really arranged. The next song that we'll be playing, excuse me, is hymn song, on a hymn song with Philip Bliss, sorry, excuse me, and conducting us will be Gustavo Fay, our wonderful student teacher. And it's a gentle, slow song, and we enjoy it very much in this band every week. And then after that, we'll be playing March, entitled Florentine March. And it was written by Julius Dukic in 1907. And it's a very exciting, very strong march that shows freedom and liberty and things that we all just want for our countries. And thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Bim bum 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 b we'll finish out with our traditional holiday chorus. So happy to have Gay Adams here singing with us. She's a very young alto. Not only does she sing with the choir, but she also plays with the orchestra and teaches languages, French. I'd like to thank Mr. Scheiber, Greg Scheiber up in the booth. And the wonderful guys that are helping him tonight. Thank you very much. So lucky to have J.P. Stevens singing, and his mother works at the West Harlem Community Television, so this is being taped. Maybe you'll see it on TV. Who knows? Thank you, Jake, for doing this. It looks like we need a new auditorium. Maybe the center aisle. So, there's so many parents that are so helpful and make our program what it is. I just would like to thank you all, those of you that brought a canned food for the West Hartford's food pantry. We really appreciate it. We try to do cans at most of the choir concerts and at these big spring and winter ones. Thank you very much. And Chuck Dorsey is our parent leader for the choirs. He is taking cans. Thanks, Chuck. We are so fortunate. You can see why we have so many ensembles and everybody's making amazing music, and that's because of the team that we have. So please hold your applause, but I'll just name them. They're the best colleagues we can work with and the most wonderful people. Gwen Cardona, Brian Jones, Dan Luongo, Grace Lee, and for our choral part of it, and of course working with Jim Antonucci and Emmett Drake every day is one of the greatest joys of my life. Holiday, of course.